Today again we are going to discuss in the continuation class the natural pesticides. So till now we have discussed the total five medicinal plants where we are getting the constituents from the different plant parts which we can use for the natural pesticides. So in today's class we are going to discuss about the Nux vomica, Rania and the citrus oil. Their use as a natural pesticides, right? So as we have discussed that these are the agent which can kill the pest, different types of pest. It may be the plant or it may be the animals, insects, virus, fungus or anything, right? So when we talk about the first one is the Nux vomica. So in Nux vomica, generally these are the seeds we are using. Here you can see in the image how the disc shaped seeds are available here. This is the schematic diagram of the Nux vomica plant. Here the seeds also it has given like okay. So let's discuss about this plant. What is there in which is helping us for the natural pesticides action and use, right? So it is also, if you see the synonyms, it is also known as the different the crow fig or stretch knee or Nux vomica seed, right? So these are the names. So if you see that Nux vomica, that stretchness means the poison, or vomica means nut, right? With vomiting effect. So it is also known as poison nut, right? That's what the meaning of stretchness. It is poison and with vomiting effect. It is also having the emetic sensation. So let's discuss about biological source. Nux vomica consists of dried ripe seeds of Strychnus nux vomica, LIN, belonging to family Loganaceae, right? Strychnus nux vomica, LIN, Loganaceae. This much you have to remember. So coming to the microscopy, if you see the color, the greenish brown color, you can see here the when it is fresh one. Right, odor none and the taste bitter in taste. Size, if you see the 10 to 30 mm of diameter, it will be there, and the 4 to 6 mm thickness. The thickness, if you can see here in the image also, the extra feature of this seed is seeds are radial disc shaped, right? As you have seen here, endosperm, cotyledons, and seen in the LS or longitudinal section of the seeds of Nux vomica, right? So these are the things we can see. Let's discuss about the microscopy little bit, how it is. The epidermis consists of thickened lignified trichomes followed by layer of collapsed cells. I told you in the last class in microscopical and powder characteristic study of the different crude drugs, right? There we have seen that how it is looking. The trichomes, like it was looking like a hairs like a structure, right? So endodermis contains thickened polyhedral unlignified cells with plasma derma, right? And oil globules also you can observe, calcium oxalate crystalline. If you go for the powder microscopy or powder characteristic of Nux vomica seeds, starch grains are absent. That you have to remember, right? Starch grains will be absent. So let's discuss about the chemical constituents, why it is useful for the natural pesticides. So indole alkaloids, right? So this is the drug, alkaloidal containing drug. Indole alkaloid is the main constituents. In the name of the different indole alkaloids are strychnine, brucine, and again strychnine, right? So this is the thing you can see, that if you go for the identification test or chemical test, the TS of Nux vomica, if you treat with the ammonium vendate and the sulfuric acid, that is called a Mandine's test, right? It will give purple color. So that is indicating the present of strychnine, right? Strychnine. And TS of Nux vomica, if you treat with the concentrated nitric acid, it will give yellow color because of the presence of brucine, B-R-U-C-I-N-E. So these are the constituents you need to remember, whatever it is in different color. No, these are the name of the chemical constituents. So use, it is a stomachic tonic due to the bitter taste, CNS stimulant. It also giving the action on the cardiovascular system. It increase the blood pressure, right? So these are the different medicinal use. other use, actually, it is the spinal cord stimulant in case of the neurasthenia, like excessive fatigue in the neurotic origin, as a circulatory stimulant and a nerve and sex tonic, bitter stomachic, it is strengthening the stomach and promoting its action. The next drug, next plant, which again we are using, the Rania, right? It consists of dried root and stems of Rania specicosa, right? Specicosa, belonging to the family, the Flacortiaceae, 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 right? Rania is a botanical insecticide made from the ground stem of Rania specicosa, a native plant of tropical America, right? It is not Indian plant, it is the tropical America, that native plant, right? The principal alkaloid in this stem extract is ranodine, right? So this you have to remember once again, which makes of approximately 0.2% of the product which we are using. Rania is a highly toxic to the fruit moth, codling moth, and the earworm, European corn borer. These are the name of the insects, and citrus thrips, but it is ineffective against cabbage maggot, cauliflower worm, and boll weevil, right? So here you can see what is the effective, what for we are studying here. It is the highly toxic for the fruit worm, food moth, codling moth, or so these are, but whereas these are ineffective against the cabbage maggot, cauliflower worm, and a boll weevil. Rania is a complex mixture of many compounds, thus no single structure would represent it, right? Because this is the complex, as you know, the natural products will be always in complex in nature. So this is the complex in nature. So the particular structure would not be represent it. Mode of action, how they are killing the poison. Rania is the slow acting stomach poison, right? The action will be slow, sustained. It will act slowly onto the stomach, although it doesn't produce rapid knockdown paralysis, right? It does cause the insects to stop feeding soon after ingesting it, right? Then a little has been published concerning its exact mode of action in insect system, right? So that's what the main, it does not produce rapid knockdown paralysis, right? And also it caused the insect to stop feeding soon after the ingesting it, right? So that is the main mechanism of action. The most active compound in Rania is the alkaloid ranodine that I already we discussed in previous slide, which constitute approximately 0.2% of the dry weight of stem wood, the location or the part of the stem wood where the ranodine type of alkaloid, it will be there in Rania plant, right? The next one or third one, that is the citrus oil extracts like limonene and linalool. These two things you should remember, from the citrus oil or from the lemon, orange, whatever the citrus fruits are there. For in that oil, if you will extract this limonene and linalool, these two types of constituent that can be used for the pesticides. So let's discuss how the crude citrus oil and the refined compounds D-limonene are, right? The hereafter referred to the simply as a limonene. So when I say limonene, it is nothing but D-limonene, okay? Na? And linalool are extracted from orange and other citrus fruit peel, right? Orange tincture you might have prepared in your first year dispensing pharmacy, right? So orange will be having these two types of chemical constituents known as limonene and linalool. that will be there into the oil, right? Which oil? Citrus oil. From there we need to extract. So limonene, and this is the limonene, a terpene. This is what? A terpene constitutes about 90% of crude citrus oil, right? And is purified from the oil by steam distillation, right? Steam distillation, these round bottom flask condenser, again another side round bottom flask, so that assembly all of you know, right? So one side we are subjecting that particular oil, and from there it will distillate and it will come into the another pot, right? So like that you can separate the limonene. Linalool, it is the terpene alcohol, right? It here limonene, it is terpenes, it is the terpene alcohol, is found in small quantity in citrus peel and in over 200 other herbs, flowers, fruits and wood. So generally this quantity, linalool quantity, will be there small, and it will be also available in other herbs or other plant, also in flower, fruit and woods also, right? So the limonene, it is more in the citrus oil, right? So terpenes and terpene alcohol, like limonene and linalool, these two are among the major components of many plant volatile and essential oils. Other component of essential oils are ketones, aldehydes, esters and various alcohols, which you have studied in your interclasses also. Essential oils are the volatile compounds responsible for most of the taste and sense of plant. That's what, whatever the good aroma or good flavor you are getting from your flower, fruit or in the any of the plant, that is because of the presence of volatile or this what you call essential oils principle, right? That's what, right? These are what, ketone, aldehyde, ether. So they are the component. So essential oil, volatile compound responsible, right? You can see in this line, essential oils are the volatile compounds responsible for most of the taste, like in mango, orange or whatever the fruit you are eating, on scent or aroma of the plant, that is because of. Many of the essential oils have also have some physiological activity also. Generally, these are the secondary metabolites, so don't have any physiological action, but in some, it is having physiological action. So let's discuss mode of action. The mode of action of limonene and linalool in insects are not fully understood, it seems, right? So it is not the how it is killing in the insects, that has not been derived till now. So let's try to understand. The limonene is thought to cause an increase in the spontaneous activity of sensory nerves, right? In almost all the natural pesticides, we could see that they're acting onto the nervous system. So the spontaneous activity of sensory nerves, it will increase, right? So this, the heightened activity sends the spurious information to motor nerves and results in twitching, lack of coordination and convulsions, right? So they will not be able to walk properly, they will die. And you might have seen that whenever you will spray something, a black heat or red heat into the, any cockroach or any insect, how they will die. They will first, they will round, then they will walk, try to walk after certain distance, they will fall down or they will try to fly, something happened, right? So ultimately what is happening, the motor nerve, whatever the information will pass, and so that will be stopped, right? And it will be interfered. So they will reach to the convulsion, or that the entire body is going to be paralyzed. The central nervous system may also be affected, right? Resulting in the additional stimulation of motor nerve. If the if it happens such, then it will, additional stimulation of motor nerves will be there. Then massive overstimulation of motor nerves leads to rapid knockdown paralysis. The body is going to paralyze and they will not be able to move here and there, and ultimately they will reach to the death, right? So essential oil are volatile, odorous oil derived from plant sources, although they are used mainly as flavoring and fragrances in foods, cosmetics, soaps and perfumes. Some of them also have insect repellent or insecticidal properties. Many essential oils have generally regarded as safe, like grass status, right? So this, what is the grass status? It is generally regarded as a safe. However, when applied topically at high concentration, they tend to be irritating to skin and mucous membrane also, right? So don't think that these are the safe or the people mindset. Generally, it is that the whatever the things it is coming from natural source or natural origin, these are safe, so we can use as much as no. When the dose or quantity will increase, definitely it is going to cause the irritation onto the skin and mucous membrane or in your dermis level, which is harmful. They are sometimes used as topical counter irritant to relieve or mask pain. Many of the essential oils that have low dermal toxicity may be toxic by ingestions, right? So the most common essential oil used as a repellents are the oil of cedar, lavender oil, and eucalyptus oil. These also can be used for the mosquito repellent, flies repellent. Small flies also will be there, right? It's like the smaller than the house flies. So for that, nowadays Bygone is there. So many heats are available, sprays are available, but ultimately here we are here to discuss about the natural pesticides. Why it is necessary, why it has been included, that because the synthetic pesticides, they are harmful for not only for the pest, but also it is, they may harm to the plant, they may harm to the soil, they may harm to the other animals and human beings also. That's what we are here to discuss about, the natural pesticide, so that we can avoid those kinds of harmful things. And moreover, the natural pesticides can be cheap also, that we have seen in the advantage and disadvantages of natural pesticides, right? So this is ultimately, the goal should be for the environmental protection. At the same time, we should be able to protect the nutritive value or medicinal value of our crop or our medicinal plants, right? So that's what using mist, we should encourage the farmers, the cultivators, the government, the other bodies that using natural pesticides are safe and effective also, right? So that you are supposed to, this much you are supposed to complete.